Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Nadeem and you are watching PLC Programming Tutorials channel. Today I'm really happy to invite one of my friend Mr. Noman on my channel. He will be talking about the DCS. He has a lot of experience working with SCADA and the DCS systems. He has an amazing YouTube channel with name IT and Automation Academy. You can go and watch his YouTube channel. He's putting a great stuff on his channel. The link for his channel is in the description box. So now I will hand over this session to Mr. Noman for further discussion about the DCS.
Thank you so much, Mr. Nadeem, for having me. Today we are going to talk about on my favorite topic, what is DCS. Before we talk about DCS, it's important to understand why we need DCS if we have a PLCs to control the operation in different industries. PLC is very good where you have large number of discrete IOs. But in industries like petrochemical, oil and gas industry, fertilizer industry, and power plants, you have large number of analog complex loops. And to handle large number of analog loops, DCS plays a great role. DCS is a computerized control system that helps you to control large number of analog loops that exist in many big process plants like oil and gas, fertilizer, petrochemical, etc. Today we will try to explain the DCS concept with easy to understand architecture. In a DCS network, you have different controllers for different areas. In a process plant, you have many areas. Like for instance, if we talk about oil and gas industry, we have well heads, we have a mine unit, we have sulfur recovery unit, and many more. In a DCS architecture, you would have a unique controller or control station for each area. Let's suppose this is area A, this is area B, this is area C. Control area A, you got one control station. In that control station, you got two controllers instead of one. One is your main controller and one is the redundant one. In the case of failure of main controller, redundant controller will take over the job. So in each area in a DCS network, you got two controllers, one main and one acting as a redundant. Like PLC, we need a field instruments to see what's going on into the process. You got different instruments like VFDs, control walls, different transmitters which are actually going to be connected to the DCS through IO cards. Like PLC, DCS have also inputs and outputs card. For analog input, DCS have analog card, and for digital input, DCS have digital input card. For analog output, DCS have analog output card, and for digital output, DCS have digital output card. Field instruments are connected to the control station in each area. Now you see here, we got another area where he got some field instruments. One of the very important questions we have that can PLC be a part of a DCS system? In some of the scenarios, you might have a PLC linked with a DCS. Or you can say that PLC is sharing the data with your DCS network. Like you can see here, PLC is connected to the field instruments. PLC is also connected to some local HMI, but this PLC is then sharing the data to the DCS controller. This is another area where we have one PLC already and we want to connect that PLC to the DCS network. We can also do that. Like we have now another area, area C, where we got different field instruments, like we got control wall, transmitters, and we have VFDs as well. These all field instruments are going to be connected to your DCS controller. Then these controllers are actually connected to one network, and that network have different systems on that. One of them is engineering workstation. What is the role of engineering workstation in DCS? If you want to create a graphics on operator screens, or if you want to write a code on individual controllers that are in different areas, you can use that engineering workstation to change a program on any specific DCS controller. You don't need to go to the site and plug in your laptop to do the modification. Instead of that, you can sit into the control room and where you got engineering workstation. This engineering workstation will help you to modify the codes on all DCS systems. Now we got another OPC server. The role of an OPC server is, for instance, this is ABB DCS. We want to talk to Siemens HMI or SCADA. We can use that OPC server in order to communicate with third party. Then we got historians. The role of historians is to store historical values. If you want to go back and see 2 years back, 3 years back, 4 years back, what was the temperature and pressure level flow or any specific process parameter value anytime in the past, you can use that historian for that reason, because historians have historical data. The job of printer here is, if you want to print any trend or any graphics, you can use that printer to print it. So then we got operator screens, and role of operator screens is, for sure, for each area you have different operator screens in a DCS. Like for instance, area A, you would have a specified operator screens for area A. The role of operator screens here is to display the graphical values of different process parameters from the field. So you got different areas, and for each area you got its own specific operator screen. That's all for DCS today. We will talk about how to program a DCS. In coming session, we would have a programming tutorials for DCS as well, which would make your concept more clear related to DCS. With that, I would conclude today's session. If you like this video, consider hitting the like button. Subscribe if you haven't yet. Till next video, take care and Allah Hafiz.